Beirut hasn't slept for 2 weeks. While some watch in sheer horror, others go floor to floor of damaged buildings, trying to save anyone they can. The IDF says it was targeting Hezbollah intelligence headquarters and weapons storage. It says it mitigated the harm to civilians by warning them to evacuate. When day breaks and the smoke clears, families mourn the dead. Neighbours say this was a civilian home, killing three sisters and their aunt. Around a quarter of the population is now displaced. The start of the public school year delayed. Classrooms instead used to shelter the displaced. The UN describing it a major crisis.
Many instances of violations of international humanitarian law in the way the airstrikes are conducted that have destroyed or damaged civilian infrastructure.
Israel hasn't yet responded to the accusation. Attacks also in Israel's northern city of Haifa. Most of Hezbollah's rockets intercepted, but some direct hits injured 10 people, damaging roads, cars and buildings. At a military base nearby, Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu discussed the IDF's future objectives in Lebanon after they declared a new closed military zone close to the border. Twelve months on since October 7, Gaza's horrors remain a reality. Thousands of people again leaving their homes in the Strip's north, as Israeli forces say they're mounting another major operation to dislodge Hamas. As the first anniversary dawned, events across Israel are being held to mark the country's dark day. No words needed in Jerusalem, where the families of hostages marched silently to the Prime Minister's home. Their demands the same for exactly 1 year. Bring their loved ones home. Rayan Tamer, SBS World News.